You're listening to Tim Fuchs on ABC Central West and Western Plains.
Now, age is knowledge, that's what I hear anyway, but it's definitely true when it comes to older members of our community teaching the younger generation skills and expertise. A new program has been launched in Orange called Grand Coaches, where members of the local Orange Grove Care Community Team team up with teenagers from special needs school, Anson Street School. The Grand Coaches typically aged over 80, and they've done all sorts of things in their lives, and they're mentoring teenagers who are in their last 2 years of high school. It sounds absolutely fantastic. Margaret Irish is the coordinator of the Grand Coaches program, and she joins me on the line. Hi, Margaret.
Good morning. Love to join you, Tim.
Oh, thank you very much for coming on this Saturday morning program. Tell me about the program.
The program is the residents at Orange Grove Care Community and students at Anson Street School. So it's very much, and it's supported by the facilitator, which is Greg Cronin, who's the founder of the Intergenerational Learning Australia. But it's very much about, we're referring to it as grand friends moving into grand mentors. So it's about building relationships and mentoring students to build upon their skills and their confidence and to build social inclusion. At the core of it, though, it's reciprocal learning and well-being for all. So the residents at Orange Grove are getting just as much out of it as the students are. So we've had students teaching residents so far how to use Lego and how to play a mean game of Uno.
I bet. Well, I was going to ask that. So when everyone meets each other, how does it work? Who talks about what?
Okay, so typically there'll be a couple of icebreakers. So there might be some joke telling, and that might be some joke telling from some students. And then residents or some of our resident comedians at Orange Grove may get up and share a joke or a story. And then there'll be some questions that we'll ask both the students and the residents, just to get their different perspectives on a particular topic. And then we might go into an activity. And that could be anything from dancing to Justin Bieber, which is what happened the other day, through to building Lego and discussing engineering and discussing careers, through to jewellery making. So it's very much about building that trust and that friendship with the plan of both, with the goal of both sides actually learning and developing from each other, so breaking down some of those barriers.
And one of the biggest things about this, as you say there, breaking down the barriers, age is not a barrier. What exactly do you mean by this, and how much do both, does everyone get out of this?
I don't think you can actually measure what everyone gets out of it in a mathematical equation, because watching the magic happen and hearing the laughter and then hearing everyone afterwards going, oh, but they talked about this and they did this and, Mum, did you know they did this? It's just magical. So in essence, aging is living. If we're living, we're actually all aging day by day, and your age doesn't define the contribution you can actually make to your community, be that a student at Anson Street or be that a resident at Orange Grove. And it's through that mateship and friendship and mentoringship we can all enjoy the reciprocal benefits of making a contribution.
Absolutely.
So watching everyone grow.
Yeah, because I've got images, and a lot of people will have watched, of course, the ABC TV show, Old People's Home for Teenagers, and, of course, I think before that was Old People's Home for Four-Year-Olds. Is it that kind of vibe?
It is along the same vein. But we're really looking to have this as a sustainable program, so not a six-week program and then goodbye, we won't see you again. It's really about developing this into a long-term relationship with ongoing benefits to all.
Absolutely.
So we've actually started to have people say, oh, can we do this in summer? Can we do this in autumn next year? So we've already got residents planning what they're going to do with their new friends or their grand friends, as they refer to them. So both sides are actually referring to the other one as their grand friends.
Wow.
The older people are actually referring to them as grand as, aren't they marvellous? And the younger people are referring to them as grand as opposed to grandparents.
Yeah.
Grand friends.
Oh, that's fantastic. So they've been meeting up. How often would you expect everyone to meet up?
They're meeting up every Thursday.
Okay.
And 9:30 they arrive up until about sort of 11:30.
What an experience. Well, congratulations. I'm so delighted to hear that. I can just imagine the look on everyone's faces and what everyone gets out of it. Thanks a lot, Margaret, for coming on the program this morning. And I'm sure others will be following along with interest how a program like this goes as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you, and congratulations to Anson Street for taking the initiative with this program.
Absolutely. Yeah, well, that's exactly right. You need not only the older members of the community, but you do need a school to sort of jump on board, and that's what Anson Street School's done here. Good on you, Margaret. Thank you very much for your time. Have a lovely weekend. That's Margaret Irish there, who's the coordinator of the Grand Coaches Program. Yes, I love the thought of that. And I watched Old People's Home for Teenagers and Old People's Home for 4-year-olds, and it was fantastic. So great to see a program like that running on a local level.